What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Star Wars The Force Unleashed. Why not Jedi Fallen Order? What the fuck, dude? I am trying to do the series. I have had run so many damn issues with it, though. Oh, trailer. Nice. But I'm having so many issues with the game. I'm sorry. Fallen Order is going to get canceled. I fucking canceled two series at this point. I know. I'm sick of Tim. I'm really angry about it. Didn't want to cancel Jedi Fallen Order. It's a fun game. I'm going to actually play that in my meantime. But damn, I'm having issues with the game, man. So many issues with it. I don't know why I'm having issues with it. Just that I can't record it right. I had to replay the whole fucking game to get back to where I was. I've been having hell with the game. So, I don't know. It's on me. You know, but I don't want to have to fucking record and record and record. But Force Unleashed is a game that they're just levels. You know, this is a game that I can actually play. We have fun. It's not a very challenging game, actually. There's one part that I hate. That's way later in the game. But here we go. Force Unleashed. I haven't played this game in a couple days. But I haven't fully beaten it in a very long time. So, yeah, it's going to be 23 hours, so it's only been a day. There's DLC. There's a lot of stuff. So what am I going to do? Raxus Prime. I've noticed I've been stopping at Raxus Prime. That's funny. I'll go override with... let's override Hoth. That's a DLC save. Oh, I didn't say press accept. I pressed cancel by mistake. Force Unleashed for Hoth. I want to play Star Wars Force Unleashed. Alright, difficulty. Sith Warrior. Sounds pretty good. This game isn't as difficult as Jedi Fallen Order, thank God. So, yeah, I did not turn off the music. Damn it, copyrighted. Star Wars. Yeah. You know what's funny? I didn't even notice, but Jedi Fallen Order doesn't have this. It doesn't have the credits. The Force Unleashed. This game actually came back about the alpha. Stroke. This game came out back in 2008. Oh my god, it's 12 years ago now. What the fuck was 2008, 12 years ago? I was almost... Oh my god. What the hell was I doing 12 years ago? Oh, the galaxy is on the brink of... Darkness, even got the Empire, has overthrown the Republic, and now the old over in the world, using fear, getting out of it all but destroyed. Only a handful have been escaped Imperial forces and disappearing into hiding sources of the galaxy. The Empire's spies have located a lone Jedi Knight on the Wookiee homeworld of Kashyyyk. The Sith Lord Darth Vader has been sent to destroy him. Oh my god, I actually can barely read that. Jesus Christ. Okay. Jesus Christ, I probably should have been reading that, then I wouldn't have to get so fucking close because my eyesight's terrible. I know, ironic, and I'm the guy wearing glasses here. You know, I didn't used to have bad vision. I used to have 20/20 vision. I guess I got older and my vision went, fuck you, and... Well. So I really want to get fucking... LASIK. Really want LASIK. Because I actually don't like wearing glasses, believe it or not. I mean, it's fine, but I mean, just... The reason I don't like wearing them is because I have to wake up, blur vision, walk around the room where the hell I put those sons of bitches and put them on. All that, and you can just... Spots get everywhere. Like, if I can wake up, I just see it, and I don't do shit. Take a shower, I'm good. That's why I don't wear contacts, either. And I'm also afraid for anything if I can goddamn lie. Here he is, Darth Vader, whose cloak looks very interesting. Yes, and some new old Vader too. Nice. Cape physics in this game is strange as hell. Also, there is actually two endings to this game. Canon ending into the dark side.
We were ambushed upon arrival, but
I'll
play both of them. Situation well in...
I have no interest in your failures, Commander. I am here on a mission of my own.
Okay, doesn't sound like James Earl Jones, but still good. Still good, Vader. I like it. Alright. Now, this game is freaking fun as hell. Now, you know how I think in the Star Wars, Jedi Fallen Order, I was talking about you can just hack and slash stormtroopers like they're nothing. We're about to scrub it out here in just a few moments. And yes, this is the fastest I can do with Vader. I think I broke Mark. That's pretty bad. I'm sorry, Wookiees. Alright, I'm gonna get a torch. Giant ass force push. Oh, I love this. If you are wondering, Vader is kind of not really the main antagonist in this game. Well, he's like a semi-main antagonist. He's a side antagonist. You know, actually, remember, you're actually playing as a Sith in this game. You're not playing as a Jedi. One of your games I know you play as a Sith throughout the whole game. Well, actually, like. Yeah, this is what I mean by they're nothing to me. God. So I don't even like using the lightsaber, because he just misses the guy when he uses the lightsaber, he just uses the force and just pushes him out the fucking way. Oh, hey, how you doing? God. This game isn't too terribly difficult from memory. I'm gonna throw him over. Bye-bye. Well, he may not be dead. Yeah, I know, you don't get to play as Darth Vader through the whole game. You can't even replay this. You can only, like... This is stupid. I don't know why you can't go back and replay this level, but... You can't. It's prologue level. You can only do it once and once only. I love using this force push. This game is so freaking awesome. Sorry, Wookiees. At least you're, friend, at least Chewie gets the big part of the story, right? How long is this before Empire? Or A New Hope? I kind of have the impression this takes place 3 years after. Or, when Empire's still very young. I got the impression Starkiller and Luke are kind of... I mean, this game isn't canon anymore. I think it was at one point. Destroy you just pieces and you just walk over it like it's nothing. Oh, and I can also use my own men too. Yeah, this one I meant by. Yeah, hold on. Are any sword troopers alive? I hope not. Because here in a minute, and especially Force Unleashed 2, you're about to learn how freaking powerful Starkiller is. Like, holy Christ, dude. Starkiller is like the most powerful son of a bitch in this game. How he wasn't the chosen one is fucking beyond me. But this dude becomes like a complete Star Wars badass. That's really why they don't consider this game canon, because a lot of people be like, how the hell did he not kill the Emperor? He can use Force Lightning, he can use pretty much everything a Sith uses, but a Jedi. So it's like a Sith of good. What Vader? You can't use a lightsaber throw with your dog. Boom. Out of my way, motherfuckers. Really, dude? You jackass. Like, let's try to walk over that, you son of a bitch. This guy, one of the few places I don't remember seeing too much in Star Wars. Very little, I don't think. I know Kashyyyk is in Star Wars Fallen Order, but. He's just not using it. Die. Die. Don't blame him. Kashyyyk wasn't even a new planet at the time. At the time, new planet. It's actually like one of the first few planets made. Fake. Holiday special. Unfortunately, it did happen. Story, but it happened at one point. Unfortunately, fuck it. Oh, come on, really? You all expect me to fall for that? Come on, I'm freaking sick. Come on now. You know what I wish Vader did have in this game? Force choke. That'd be so fun, just like going around choking on the enemies. I'm not taking one piece of health. No, I think I'm taking some damage. Get the hell out of my face. Kill like 15 of these guys. I must have like the highest death count ever. I wonder why Anakin just like slaughtered the Jedi with ease.
Whatever you
see, if there was any Sith that would not want to come after me, it'd be Darth Vader or Emperor Palpatine. Darth Maul. From me. Pretty much everyone else except Dooku. I think I could take Dooku. Because he's actually not the... Well, he's evil, but he's not like... Maul, where he's like a friggin' psychopath. He's just... doesn't believe in the Jedi. Oh yeah, we're gonna saber lock too. I love these. Although the QTEs. Crack his neck. Okay, what is this voice actor's name, by the way? I've heard him in so many things. And the tree's broken in the way. I mean, the freaking lightsaber throw. Nice! That's how you do it. It's like, pick him up and throw him. Lightsaber throw. Oh man. And yes, you do get to fight Darth Vader at the end of the game. Because in every Star Wars game, I'm gonna force your case actually. This feels like a button mash every time. Stab him. Stab him while he's down. Oh shit. Vader, why do you walk so slow? I know you're cool and all, but dang. Look, you're very intimidating and cool, Darth. But I don't know why you keep fucking walking like you've got fucking man up your ass. Damn it. So I'm talking about Jennifer, and also, when it comes to fucking force powers, saying it's not the first game where he's like super powerful and he's like told Star Wars badass how he didn't get to beat the Emperor in the film. That's Force Unleashed 2. They introduced something in that game that's like, good god, how is this guy and not the chosen one? This game is very realistic. He's Force user, he's good with the Force, he's about average, he's an average Sith. He's like a less angry Darth Vader. Okay, let's defeat this guy real quick. Alright, press B. And now we get the choke. I just wish this was more available. And I just a little QTE. And dead. Didn't the Separatists have Kashyyyk? I'm lost Revenge of Sith.
Sent someone far more powerful nearby. Where is your master?
The dark side has clouded your mind. You killed my master years ago.
Then now you will share his fate. A son.
Run!
So I kind of wonder if he took in his Starkiller because... he never had Luke, or he doesn't think he had Luke. Well, that's us.
Come with me. Maul will be here soon.
Gee, I wonder why he took in Starkiller, because he never had Lee. He thinks his son is dead. For his kids.
You were weak when I found you. Now your hatred has become your strength. At last, the dark side is your ally. Rise, my apprentice.
What is your will, my master?
Your training is nearly complete.
So sometimes you okay, and why they always say that test. Is kind of British.
Your spies
don't know why.
Jedi.
Yes. Master Ron Kota. He is attacking a critical Imperial shipyard. Destroy him and bring me his lightsaber.
I shall leave at once, Master.
What the hell does Vader do? He's running a professional in this.
Leave no witnesses. Kill everyone aboard, Imperials and Kota's men alike.
As you wish, my master.
Do you see what I mean? When he says master, he goes British, but every time he speaks in a... well, American accent, I get it. Obi-Wan! Wrong! He had the high ground. He should have won that.
Another excellent duel.
How the hell are you dead?
Catching me by surprise. I haven't fought that training program in years. I thought you'd erased it.
I'd hoped that using an older training module would catch you off guard and allow me to finally kill you. I'm sorry I failed you again.
Well, I'm sure you'll keep trying.
Yeah, but okay.
Don't ambush me.
Apparently, if you cut a fucking robot in half, they don't die?
Proxy.
Yes, why are we whispering?
Shh, who's that?
Yes. Your new pilot has finally arrived, Master. Accessing Imperial records.
Captain Juno Eclipse, born on Korolag, where she became the youngest student ever accepted into the Imperial Academy. Decorated combat pilot with over 100 combat missions, and commanding officer during the bombing of Kalos. Handpicked by Lord Vader to lead his Black Five squadron, but later reassigned to a top secret mission.
Is there a psychological profile in there too?
Actually, yes. But it's restricted. Oh, Master, I can tell you she's going to be impossible to reprogram.
Do you know why you're here?
Yes. My orders are clear. I'm to keep your ship running and fly you wherever your missions require.
Did Vader tell you that he killed our last pilot?
No. But I can only assume that he gave Lord Vader good reason to do so. I will not.
Well, let's hope so. I'm sick of training new pilots.
Vader's killed out of no goddamn reason before. Vader just killed people because he fucking feels like it. He has no goddamn mercy in his right effort. Vader doesn't. Anyway.
Any suspect ships within the entire system. You are one of Vader's spies.
Only if you piss him off.
You don't need to know anything about my missions except where I'm going. Now I need to jump to Nar Shaddaa. Can you handle that?
Nar Shaddaa? Is that even a real planet anymore? See, this game I don't think is canon anymore, but I don't even know if it really was. The weird thing about these games are there's... For some reason in... Star Wars in
welcome aboard,
this game, there's two endings, the light side and the dark side
excellent.
Endings.
Similarly,
but they made a sequel and they confirmed the light side ending is the true ending.
Excellent, Master. Now,
which makes
prove
sense,
your mastery
right?
Of grip by using
but
the
in, since there's no third game ever going to release, which kind of sucks, because I was actually a little curious on how this game would have been with third. These are hack and slash games. They really are. The second one's more of a hack and slash. This one's more of a... Yeah, it's a hack and slash, pretty much. This is not a very hard game. It's actually...
Well done,
a game you play just to...
You have completed.
Play. Like, if you want to sit down and play a game, just play, like... Force Unleashed. If you're... just bored. This is a game I can play when I'm bored. Or whatever. No, so the starfighter is still being built. I feel so bad for the people who have to build that.
According to Imperial records, Master Rom Kota was a respected general in the Clone Wars.
How the fuck does he do that?
You're hunting Jedi.
I bring Darth Vader's enemies to justice. Now so do you.
Master Kota was a military genius, but felt that clone soldiers were unfit for battle. Instead, he relied on his own militia.
So, there were no clones in his squad when Order 66 was issued.
And after Order 66, he vanished. Official Imperial records actually claim he's dead.
Wipe him out of hiding.
So, how does Vader know he's alive?
He wants to be found.
Then we're walking into a trap.
No shit.
How many pilots have you lost before me?
7.
Excellent. Coordinates for Nar Shaddaa are locked.
Nar Shaddaa.
Lock down the command center and get that hologram projector up and running.
Yes, sir.
Tell all squads to fan out and funnel any opposition towards us.
Man, I forgot.
Explosive charges
there was,
on levels 2,
you know what's weird?
And 12, just like we planned.
General Kota.
Somehow, there are some games back in 2008 that looked better than 2013 games. Batman Arkham Origins is one of them. This game looks better than Batman Arkham Origins. And Arkham City, which came out 2 years
lower
before
the
that. Then,
field on hangar 12,
I don't know why that came into mind, but there are some games that still look better than others, somehow. In 2013, I remember like, there were so many games that... Well, games aren't very good, like 2013.
I'll be moving the Rogue Shadow out of firing range while you attend to your mission.
Last of Us. That didn't even look good until remastered.
And I will provide whatever intelligence support I can via your comlink.
Yes, I just dissed on The Last of Us. But I'm saying, the PS4 remaster is so much better and kind of the definitive version of The Last of Us. Feels like the one that was supposed to come out on. Alright. So is Nostradamus just a space station? Guess so. And remember, the Imperials don't know I exist, or I must murder every single one of them. I finally get a reason to be a psychopathic murderer! Sweet. If you're wondering, yes, you also get more lightsabers, lightsaber colors, and all that. You also have skins in the game, which I think I actually have some right now. Costumes. I actually have some skins I can use, but I'm not gonna use them right now. DLC, so you got Anakin, Darth, Sion, Imperial Commando, Kephisto, Luke, Anakin, Giuliani Mundi, General Starkiller, older him, I guess, Hooded Combat Gear, Sith Assassin, Dark Lord's Armor, Spirit Apprentice, that's further, Republic Trooper, Luke, Tatooine Luke, Utility Combat Suit, Ben Kenobi, animated style, so I guess it's Clone Wars, Plo Koon, Count Dooku, Jango Fett, C-3PO, training gear, and there's more costumes to unlock, and for some reason, even if you get to the DLC, you have to use a cheat to get Palpatine, which is kind of ridiculous to me. But yes, Palpatine is available to play as. So. This game is pretty interesting, but this is pretty much the main game, just going around, chopping people off. Yeah. Thankfully, I played this game so many times on another game. Alright. Come on, up. Like I said, this is not a very new game. This game came out freaking 12 years ago.
The readouts are showing the hangar bulkhead has been sealed. You'll need to find a way through that door.
Who's that? How did I do to begin with? I sure just can't fight it. Don't know how, but I have. Die! I think I die very much in this game, actually. I'm low force. I must kill every single one of you rebel bastards. Come on, you rebel scum. I must kill you. Yeah, and if you kill a certain amount of enemies, you can jump back. And the slowest moving force of all time. Good God, who's using the force here? Yoda? There you go, that's good. Escape the hate. Style. Try to me with different power combos each turn the points. Well, I'm so early in the game, so well. Okay, how many levels are there? I think it's like 15. I mean, I have another file with the Death Star, so. Yes, you go to the Death Star in this game. Death Star in this game. Which I think is complete. So this game makes me want to say this game kinda is right before New Hope. I don't know though. It's like right before Rogue One and a little bit after Solo. It's kinda where I want to put it in timeline. But it's not canon, so don't really think about that. You know, if they see a red lightsaber, they should kind of say, hey, he's a Sith, he might be on our side.
Eclipse to Starkiller. I've intercepted a message from the flight tower. The Imperials have mobilized a TIE fighter squadron in your sector. Keep your eyes open.
I didn't realize how much I'm not really paying attention to the package. There you go. Easy. And after this series, I'm probably going to do... I might do Force Unleashed 2. Force Unleashed 2, Life is Strange 2. Because we did last year in like either November or December, maybe it was we did the original Life is Strange. Ooh, I got a Force Talent here. Nice. Use the Force! Jump him up! Alright, we're going to. I can smash my way through.
Schematics show a lift nearby that can take you to the upper levels.
That's amazing. Yeah, you will always learn new things about this game. It's just a holocron? What is this? What? General holocron to obtain. Nice! Like super crystals. So, did I unlock a new lightsaber crystal? Meaning new color? Yeah, so you can unlock new colors. You can unlock black, blue, different types of blue, green, yellow, purple, yellow. So I guess that other one was orange, but it looks like yellow. There's also force upgrades, which I can actually use right now. Yeah, for some force talents, so let's see what we get. What's this? Increases your maximum health. Increases your maximum force energy. Speed, you recover force energy. The amount of health you regain by defeating your enemies. Sabermaster. So far, the best sounding one. I'm gonna go with this one. I'm gonna go with Fortitude. Just the extra health never hurts. So, or it helps not dying. Alright. It helps with not dying as much. Not to use the force, but to use the bitches. We'll probably be fully upgraded by the end of the game. Which is. I don't think this game is very long. This is like a 6-hour campaign, maybe 10-hour campaign. So not a super long game. Kind of like a average game length back in 2008. Hell, games today usually take about 2 days if I just sat down and play. Really want to play the Force Unleashed. So I'm probably going to do this for a little bit. I think. But I've noticed I've always kind of stopped at Rex's crimes. So there must be a reason. I really should look up how many books there are. Just to know. Yeah, this is also back when there were things called levels in video games, but not missions. Or just little simple tasks and side missions. Good God. I swear, recent games have, like, kind of have levels, but they really got rid of those. Feels like they got rid of levels. That's right, I don't have the lightsaber throw yet. I better unlock that in Force or in Jedi Fallen Order. I really want to throw my lightsaber at some stormtroopers. Which I know which file I can play that one on, thank you. Because it can't be the series, unfortunately. I might get back to the series one day, but I'm gonna keep canceling right now. Ooh, Jedi Holocron, nice. Nice, I got a level up. Let's see what I got. Meaning I can unlock more things. What can I unlock? Loading. Alright. Okay. Alright. Got Force Lightning. Lightsaber Throw. Force Powers, I think I'm just gonna get Force Push, just get more. Force push, yeah. Force talents, we can unlock something else. Force energy, I want this one. Force, recover it. Force affinity, want that. Affinity, yeah, you unlock a lot of this pretty early on, actually, I'm thinking about. What's this? It says. Oh. Saber Sling XXA? XXB? Sounds interesting. Let's try it out. Oh, I don't know this. That's where you. Okay, let's try it out real quick. I need a game. Alright, how about. Yeah, he does that with it, which is awesome. I love the combos in this game. Alright, let's try it out real quick. Alright, there here we go. Now let's start using some combos. Well, anyway, I think I'm going to end that episode here. I know I'm kind of out of the blue, but, well, it's been about 30 minutes, unfortunately. So, anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Star Wars The Force Unleashed, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Buh.